500 cc, twee takt, viercilinder met een dikke 150 pk.
This race marks the debut of his brand new V4 engine, an engine that Bieland has developed himself and is hoping that it will be the future of sidecar racing. It's some 6 kilograms lighter than the Yamaha engine also used in sidecar racing and has produced 175 brake horsepower on the dyno. But this is its first race debut.
It
has been tested fairly considerably at some of the French race tracks. And they're feeling very, very confident for this, its first race outing. But a few suspension problems in qualifying, certainly affecting Bieland, as the sidecar outfit certainly bouncing around a lot over the bumps.
Derek Brindley and Paul Hutchinson.
Derek Brindley and Paul Hutchinson, the British pairing, who've had a strong year, certainly with the win at the season opener at Donington, but looking to try and get a good result here to confirm second place in the championship.
Derek Brindley samen met Paul Hutchinson, 24 jaar en jong, deze monteur uit Engeland. Winnaar verrassend in Donington Park dit jaar. Een oud gediende hier, Steve Webster. Dit jaar rijden met Adolf Henny. De LCR Krauser combinatie. Hij nog met de vertrouwde krachtbron. 23 Grand Prix
Steve Webster, the man who's going to be trying to stop them taking second place in the series. And this man also with a chance, Marcus Boesinger with Jörg Egli. Also trying to take that runners-up position behind Bieland and Vultisberg.
Voor Webster in de trainingen.
Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington.
Is Dixon die in derde tijd in zit.
Winners in the championship already this year. Well, they don't have a chance of taking second place in the series. But nevertheless, they'd like to finish off the season on a high note.
Webster. Darren Dixon, goed voorin dus. Terwijl men gespannen naar de monitoren kijkt, want wie zal er een pole position neerzetten? En het is inderdaad deze combinatie, Bieland Valtisberg, die met het nieuwe motorblok...
Bieland en Valtisberg, managing to sort out their suspension troubles. And with their new engine, getting pole position once again here in Barcelona. Another superb effort from the Swiss pairing.
We sind hier beim Grand Prix in Barcelona.
Well, this is Rolf Bieland saying we are here at the Grand Prix in Barcelona. We have pole position after an absolutely superb lap. But that superb lap had to be timed with very great accuracy. So let's find out from Longines just how they go about that. Well, the main man from Longines explaining how that timing system works. And he says we have the most modern equipment for timing in the world.
Now, accurate system.
Thousands of a second.
We kunnen alles meten tot op de duizendste van een seconde.
To do that, we use three different parts to the system. We have a small transponder attached to the motorbike. And when the bike passes the line, an impulse is picked up and relayed directly to the timekeeper's box.
De tijd doorgeeft aan de computer. Dan zien we dat streepje lopen.
Each unit has its own frequency. So there can be no confusion between the different outfits.
Uit drie delen wordt ons ook verteld. Iedereen krijgt zijn eigen frequentie, wordt ons ook verteld, zodat er geen fouten kunnen worden gemaakt.
The second part is a photoelectric system. The combination works in that a light beam is produced, which the motorbike breaks as it crosses the line.
Hier een combinatie doorheen rijdt. Wordt er een lichtstraal onderbroken?
One of the timekeepers punches in the number of the bike as it crosses the line.
Wordt hier ook die tijd vastgehouden.
And in that way we can check the lap time on each occasion.
Dan wordt de tijd nog eventjes rondgeroepen hierboven en nog eens even met de hand genoteerd om alle moeilijkheden tegen te gaan, eventuele moeilijkheden. Eigenlijk de oude methode is dit. En dan hebben we nog een derde systeem om alles helemaal sluitend te maken. Een super video systeem.
This is a camera which produces 100 pictures per second. These pictures are recorded along with the time.
Kunnen worden ontleed op dit systeem en dit is een geweldig wapen voor de wedstrijdleiding. We kunnen hier een foto finish zien.
Is to decide in the case of a close finish.
Wat de tijd was.
Can be seen by the race stewards.
De combinatie worden op deze foto position.
De sportcommissie overgeven.
All the times which are recorded are fed then into our base.
Alles wordt een truck bestuurd.
That moves around with our equipment,
vrachtwagen die hier staat, volgepropt met elektronica.
We can beam it.
Hier worden alle gegevens verzameld
in various key areas around the circuit, in
the
press room,
back to the teams in the pit lane,
and also if the TV stations are following the race, then we can directly feed the times to them so that they can put them up onto the screen.
Dat Fernsehen dabei ist, werden diese Zeiten je nach Wunsch des Regisseurs weitergegeben in die Zentrale vom Fernsehen. Und das Fernsehen blendet diese Zeiten für den Konsumenten zu Hause wieder auf den Bildschirm.
Und so kriegen wir dann die Zeiten in de huiskamers te zien. Are produced. En er wordt natuurlijk ook by Longines gebruik gemaakt van klantpapier. En dat voor de persmuskieten rond het circuit die doorgaat de laatste tijden zien.
It certainly shows us that Rob Bieland was able to take pole position by over a second from his nearest opposition, which was led by Steve Abbott and Julian Telford, second fastest. We'll be back with the race. Back here on Eurosport, back on Speed World, as we get ready now for the final race in the sidecar world championship. Rolf Bieland brings his unit onto pole position with a spectacular time in qualifying with his brand new V4 engine. Second fastest then, Steve Abbott and Julian Telford, also with a new engine, but this a more normal inline 4 ADM power unit. Third fastest, Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington.
Darren Dixon, die het weer bijzonder snel had gedaan samen met Andy Hetherington in de trainingen.
And fourth on the grid, Marcus Boziger and Joel Egli. Remember the battle for second place in the championship between Boziger,
Brindley
and the next man on the grid, Steve Webster. Webster hasn't had quite as successful season as he would have hoped. No wins in 1994. Perhaps he can do better this time. Paul Hutchinson ready to sit alongside Derek Brindley. Those two going for second place in the championship as well, remember. Seventh on the grid, Klaus Kloffenbeck with his passenger Christian Partzer. The Goodall brothers are next up on the grid. Paul and Charlie
with their
unit on the outside of row three. Back onto row four, the Egloff twins. And then it's Kumagaya and Steve Poynter. And on the fifth row of the grid, the three outfits ready to go include Barry Brindley and the Finn, Lars Leto, along with Tony Wiesen from Switzerland. Ready for the start of the race then, and the grid all settled and in position as we get ready for the start of 22 laps here at Barcelona. And away they go. Can Rolf Bieland and Kurt Woltersberg make a better start than normal? Well, yes, they have. They've made a much better start than they have done in several races so far this year. But nevertheless, Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington are challenging them into the first corner. And in fact, it looks as though the British pairing have taken the lead from the Swiss world champions as Paul and Charlie Goodall going very well and diving into fourth place. Just behind Klaus Kloffenbeck, and there Steve Abbott, who made a rather poor start from the front row of the grid, is now trying to make up for that and work his way back up into this lead group. Up front, the battle going on between Darren Dixon, Rolf Bieland and Derek Brindley just behind him as well. The second of the British pairings there in third position, and they're being chased by Paul and Charlie Goodall, the Swiss pairing on the number four outfit.
And Paul Hutchinson.
So still leading is Darren Dixon. And Bieland gets it sideways. Bieland loses control and goes off just into the gravel track. In fact, Derek Brindley gets very badly held up in that incident as well. Well, Bieland just losing it on the brakes on the entry to the downhill left-hander. He got away from him. And the Swiss seven times world champion, even he can make mistakes. So that's dropped him right to the back of the field now. And he really has a lot of work to do. But for poor old Derek Brindley as well, it's meant that his race is now going to be an awful lot harder than he had intended. Up front, Darren Dixon is leading at the moment and certainly trying to extend a little bit of a lead. That's certainly what he's achieving already. He's opened up a fair bit of a gap, and Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington, who won at Zeltweg in Austria earlier this year, are looking very, very good here. Klaus Kloffenbeck in second place, coming under pressure from Steve Webster and Adolf Hanni. And it looked to me as though the number two unit may have got through. Yes, indeed. Webster goes up into second place. And now he can go chasing after Darren Dixon. Klaus Kloffenbeck not ready to see that second place, though. In fact, Kloffenbeck is coming back at him as they head down towards the first corner. Dixon. But up front, Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington really are putting on an excellent display of control driving up at the front of the field. Still the battle going on for second place a little further back. And in fact, it looks as though Mark Tiloy and David Horn have come up into second place. And that's a bit of a surprise. They're just ahead there of Steve Webster. Well, Webster just cutting through, trying to get past. And back into that second position. But at the moment, Mark Tiloy, oh, he nearly lost it there. Got a big wiggle And David Horn had to hold on tight to avoid being thrown off the machine, but hold on, he did indeed. But Steve Webster goes up into second position. And the two British teams are now first and second. But Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington on the Pagets Racing LCR ADM certainly have got the measure of the opposition at this stage.
Want het is toch glad. De grip is zeer laag te noemen.
Dixon, 33 years old, started his sidecar racing back in 1990. Before that, he raced solo motorcycles, so he's got a fair bit of experience. And this year has certainly been a good year for him. He led at Donington as well, only to go out of the race. But look at this battle for third, fourth and fifth places. We've got five outfits all battling for position. It's Charlie and Paul Goodall who are holding on to that third place at the moment. But they've got Yoshi Kumagaya and Steve Pointer right behind them. In fourth position.
Als dat maar goed gaat, denk
and
je
also
zo,
involved in that
is
little battle.
Een hoe die
Mark Tilloy. Oh, and we've got somebody in the pits. It's Barry Brindley and Scott Whiteside.
Barry
Derrick's brother.
And
it doesn't look as though he's having much luck either. Neither of the Brindley family are enjoying very good opening laps here.
Door het veld
van
het jagen komt helemaal vanaf een laatste positie.
Battle for third place going on.
En u ziet hem dan alleen op
Charlie Goodall there
in
the number four outfit.
Hier de mannen Goodall en Goodall.
Right behind them, Klaus Klaffenbach and Christian Patzer from Austria. On the number three OKM racing team.
Christian
Patzer with the Bartel engine. Slightly unusual power unit.
En achter de Oostenrijkers.
Klaus Klaffenbach, or unusual tuner, tuned by the Bartel tuning company, but they've put in some good results this year. They haven't taken any wins, but they have had a second place at Assen in Holland, and another good result at Assen at the second race in Holland as well, with a fourth place. But look at this, they're challenging for third now, and trying to get past to Google, and indeed they do, so they go up into third. But look at this, Bieland and Voltisberg have now joined into this battle. Remember, they went right to the back of the field, and now they suddenly appear in third place. Well, that's a remarkable recovery drive from the Swiss champions, who dropped right to very last position after that spin on the opening lap, and now they're already up into third position. Up front is still the battle going on between Darren Dixon, Andy Hetherington in the lead of the race, and Steve Webster and Adolf Hanny in second place. But Webster and Hanny have definitely closed up, and the battle is definitely on now for the lead. Of Bieland and Kurt Voltisberg in third place. Well, they're not getting away as comfortably as we might have expected from Klaus Klaffenbach and Christian Patzer. But Charlie Goodall, Paul and Charlie Goodall dive through on the inside and retake Klaffenbach and Patzer. So still this battle rages for fourth position. Webster definitely that little bit closer to Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington. And Webster, the man who's taken four world championships in sidecar racing, looking now to try and take the lead away. Another problem here for Benny Janssen and Frans Gurtz van Kessel with the number 18 unit. Their race is over as the battle for fourth place between the Goodles and Klaffenbach still rages.
Om de vierde plek. Goodall geeft alles.
Bieland takes a little check in his mirror there.
En wat loopt deze machine unusual als vergif? Dat is een
in the fact that he runs that little mirror on his outfit. Many of the other competitors choosing to not worry about what's behind them by looking in their mirrors, simply by checking over their shoulder. But look at this battle up front, and in fact there's a change of the lead because Steve Webster has just taken Darren Dixon. So a change for the lead. And Webster, the experienced world champion in the past, takes the lead from Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington.
So they're back down to second position.
But as there's some rain now beginning to fall, perhaps that's the reason for Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington dropping back. We see David Hoskin and David James out, and Kieran Kavanagh and Michel van Pivel as well. Well, the red flag has come out, in fact, and the rain getting heavier and heavier, as you can see from the camera lens, and conditions getting very difficult indeed. So Steve Webster using his experience to the full to take the lead from Darren Dixon in the slippery conditions, but the red flag has come out and the decision has been made to turn it into a wet race and make it a two-part race now. So the time from the first part of the race will be considered. A second part of the race will be run with the outfits now running on wet tires. You can see the wets now having been fitted to the outfit of Rolf Bieland and Kurt Voltisberg. And as the crowds
raise their spirits. Al de Spanjaarden daar een soort van regenbezweringsdans inzetten.
The outfits get ready to come back out onto the grid. To restart this second part of the race. Now remember, it will be an aggregate result from the two races added together. So Steve Webster and Adolf Hany, they were leading when the red flag came out from Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington in second position. And we have 16 laps to go in this restarted race. Everybody on wet tyres now. Let's get the race underway once again. And Rolf Bieland and Kurt Voltersberg starting from the front row, having got up into third place before that first leg came to its conclusion. And in fact, they take the lead from Lausletto in second place, Dixon in third. Or is it because it looks as though Goodall is coming around the outside of Darren Dixon as they went into that first corner? And indeed, yes, Goodall has come up into third position, Dixon in fourth, then Abbott in fifth position, and Webster dropped down to sixth place. A very poor start from Steve Webster, the man who led across the line when the race was stopped at the end of the first leg. But he needs to do an awful lot better than that start, and he's dropped right down the order. But look at how Bieland and Voltersberg already getting away from Goodall, who now moves up into second position. And Paul and Charlie Goodall really are running very well here in Barcelona.
Abbott is er ook goed bij nu, met een nieuw motorblok voor hem. Waren de resultaten toch een stuk beter, vooral in de trainingen. En hier glimmert Rolf Bieland samen met Kurt Waltersberg
in this 1994 season. And if they could possibly win this race, it would be their 76th victory in sidecar racing for Rolf Bieland and Kurt Waltersberg. An incredible record. And really, they have been the dominant team in sidecar racing for so many years now. But in fact, Rolf Bieland actually announced that he will be retiring. Has done enough to take victory. Paul and Charlie Goodall take the checker flag first, but it's Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington to win the event on aggregate. A superb end to their season and their second championship victory of the year. Delight in the pits as well for the team, and victory by 10 seconds in the end for Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington over the Goodalls in second place. Steve Abbott and Julian Telford in third position, with Klaus Klaffenbach in fourth, Derek Brindley in fifth, and Lars Leto in sixth position. Well, in the championship battle for second place, it means altogether that Steve Webster has managed to hold on to that second place in the title race with his finish, and he scored 104 points at the end of the season. But victory on this occasion for Darren Dixon and Andy Hetherington, who complete the 94 season in seventh.